A very good afternoon to all of you. Today we will discuss about the topic safe laboratory practice and biomedical waste disposal. It is a very important topic when you enter first time in the laboratory. So what are the safety rules when you work in the laboratory? Okay, so there are some safety rules. These are very important to follow these rules when you are working in the laboratory in the safety point of view. If you don't follow, you can face many chemical, physical and bio hazards. There are some laboratory rules. Proper lab attire. Always dress properly during a lab activity. Always wear apron and gloves and eye protection spectacles. Long hair must be tied up and shoes most completely cover the foot. Avoid eating, drinking and storing eatable in the laboratories. Don't use the glasswares or don't use the glasswares as a container for the food. All the apparatus in the laboratory should be handled properly. There will be no running in the lab. Always make sure to walk because there will be some materials, equipments that can be break. So please walk carefully. Handling the chemicals. Almost chemicals are the dangerous. So be careful while handling these reagents or the chemicals like concentrated acids and the alkalis or phenols. Keep the distance and don't taste the chemicals or the reagents. Always check the label on the chemical bottles twice when you used. Always return back the chemical as its original place. Another rules are handling the equipment or glassware properly. Before you start heating, be sure that the outer surface of the test tube is dry. Hot glassware must be kept on a dry surface. Don't transfer the pipette from one reagent to the another. Reagent must not be poured back into the reagent bottle. Okay, if any chemical splash in your eyes or on your skin, then immediately wash it with the running water at least 10 minutes. Keep hands away from the face, eyes, mouth and the body while you working with the chemical or the lab equipments. Wash your hand properly with soap or disinfectant and water after completion of your work. Dispose all the chemicals and waste material properly. Never throw filter paper or cotton in the sink. Use always dustbin to dispose these materials. Don't use broken glassware. Don't immerse hot glassware in the cold water. Always examine glassware when you used. Never used cracked or dirty glassware. Before you leave the laboratory, wash and clean all the apparatus and glassware. Replace it and put into the proper place. So these are the some rules that you follow before you enter in the laboratory. Another topic is biomedical waste disposal. Biomedical waste is the waste that is generated or that is produced during the diagnosis, testing, treatment, research or in the production of the biological product of human or the animals. This is called biomedical waste. Generally 75 to 90% of the biomedical waste is non-risky and 10 to 25% of the biomedical waste is risky. The hospital waste is very risky for the patients and the persons who handle this biomedical waste. So, the proper management of the biomedical waste is essential to maintain hygienic cleaning or the control of the environmental pollution. The Government of India notified the National Biomedical Waste Rules in the July 1998. According to this rule, all the healthcare facilities in the country are covered under these rules, making it mandatory for such health facility to manage their waste. After some time, the Ministry of the Environment and Forest replaced the Act 1986 and 1998 and the rule allowed in 2016. These rules may be called as biomedical waste management rules. About 70 to 90% of the waste material or biomedical waste is non-hazardous or non-risky, but 20 to 25% of the waste considered as hazardous or infectious or risky. If the segregation doesn't take place, then all the waste that produced 100% should be considered as infectious when it is mixed. WHO has classified hazardous waste into the different categories like infectious waste, pathological waste, sharp things, pharmaceutical waste, chemical waste, radioactive material waste, waste with the heavy metals, pressurized containers. These are the some category of the waste material. Exposure to the hazard healthcare waste can result in the disease or in the injury due to one or more of the following characteristics like infection, genotoxicity, chemical and pharmaceutical toxicity, radioactivity hazards, and public sensitivity. These are the international symbol for the biological hazard. Some different location that generate the biomedical waste. These locations are hospitals, nursing homes, dental clinic, dispensaries, primary healthcare centers, animal house, blood banks, laboratory, medical research, etc. These are the different location that produced biomedical waste. How we can dispose this biomedical waste? So biomedical waste shall be treated by one of the following method. First one is incineration, means burn the biochemical waste. Second treatment is wet and dry thermal treatment. Third one is chemical disinfection. Fourth one is microwave irradiation. Fifth one is land disposal. And last is inertization. It is the explosion protection process that use the inert gas to prevent the formation of an explosive mixture. There are some containers that we can use for the discard of the waste material. These containers or poly bags are yellow in color, red, blue, white, and somewhere is green. In the yellow container or yellow bags, we can discard human anatomical waste, animal anatomical waste, soil waste, chemical waste, discarded medicines, chemical liquid waste. So these type of waste we can store or we can discard it into the yellow colored polythene or container. In the red color container or in the red color bags, we can dispose or we can discard syringe, bottles, vacutainers, tubes, gloves, mask, etc. in the white container or in the white polythene, we can discard needles, syringe, scalpels, blade, and any other sharp content. In the blue container or in the blue bags, we can discard broken glassware, medicines, cytotoxic waste, and metallic body implants. So these are the different color containers that we can use for the discard of the waste material. These are yellow, red, blue, white, and green. In the safe laboratory practice, a one rule: don't fill the test tube more than half. But in the laboratory, it is a one test that we can fill the 2.5 of the test tube. So tell me the name of this test. Which test in which we fill the 2.3 of the test tube sample. Tell me the name of this test. Nobody knows. Okay, leave it. So this is all about the safe laboratory practice and biomedical waste disposal. From this topic, a short question can be asked, but it is important for your knowledge. Okay, thank you.